Hi all and welcome. We'll just zoom in here to Sydney, Australia, and I'll show some alignments. I've shown some of these already, so I'll be re-showing a bit of material, but I'll also be looking at a bit of new material that I have. So I'll just bring this map across here, and we have an alignment that I've already shown from Sydney Uni, which is right here. That is the quadrangle of Sydney Uni, and this alignment goes to the Mercure Hotel here. And there is a park here, and it goes from the quadrangle across the grounds and through this path in Victoria Park, and then it perhaps ends up here at the Mercure Hotel. Of course, this is a very old building, and the Mercure Hotel is actually quite a modern building at what is Railway Square, which is right here. So let's just we'll start off by having a little look at the grounds of Sydney Uni at the quadrangle. I'm just bring this across right here, and we can see the quadrangle there, and in the middle of the quadrangle is a sort of an octagonal shape just there. So that's the quadrangle, and that's our tangent going off, and we'll just zoom out a bit and I'll draw the map across, and there we can see it heads across these gates and it lines up over here with the Mercure Hotel, zooming into that. Now from the Mercure Hotel we have a swimming pool just here, and as you look across the swimming pool here, you can see that it does, and it definitely has been architecturally designed to line up with the clock tower of the Central Railway Station, which is right here, and I think that's pretty plain to see. This is a Masonically designed building. And I think it would be pretty safe to say that the Mercure Hotel would go along similar lines. And of course, Mercure relates to Mercury. In front of the Mercure Hotel, we have these pyramidal shapes with these tall stands on them, and you can see the shadows of them in this shot with the lights on them, and we'll talk a bit more about those, but at the moment, we'll just have a closer look at a line going through those. So I've drawn a line from the top of the Mercure Hotel here. Well, really it starts here at this one here, which is one of those pyramidal shapes, and it goes from here through the fourth one. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 of these pyramids, and in this case I've drawn a line from the first one through the fourth one, and that line tends to go out, and basically it meets with the Masonic building at number 66 Golden Street. So I'll just zoom into that for a moment, and that is the building there at number 66 Golden Street. So whether that's a coincidence or not, I'm not sure, but the main part of the building, the Masonic building, is actually in this area right here on the corner of Goulburn Street and Castlereagh Street, just there. So there's a possible alignment there, although I'm not reading too much into that. And then plus we have this alignment here and this alignment here. So we'll carry on. So let's do a very brief orientation of Railway Square in Sydney. So this is the area here for the most part. We have the awnings just here, the primordial waters, if you will, the four towers, the pyramids with the pylons and lighting rigs, 1, 2, 3, and then across the road here, 4. We have a fountain just here that I refer to as a womb-esque fountain that perhaps ties in with this. Over here we have Orchard's Corner, built in 1910. We'll have a look at that. The Wake Up building just there. We have the Marcus Clark building here. Marcus Clark was a Freemason. We have this building here, which is the Mercure Hotel. It has the Elements bar in it. It has Eve's Place also. You can see the wavy awning here. We will have a look at that area as well. And this part here protects the swimming pool, which is just under here, virtually on the rooftop of the Mercure Hotel. And that looks across to the clock tower of the railway building that we can't see in this shot. We'll also have a look from this alley here towards a billboard that happened to be on the Mercure Hotel, and we'll perhaps take a look from here as well. There are a couple of Masonic pillars just here, and we'll go from there. So I'm just outside the Mercure Hotel here in Sydney, looking across to the Marcus Clark building, and at the base of it we can see the pyramids. In between the pyramids we can see the waters. We can also see the waters here and the pyramids, the Benben pyramids. Here we can see the pyramids with the water. And across the other side here are the pyramids, Benben stones, again with the waters. These awnings are the waters. Just as we see here with the waters between the pyramids. Railway Square here with the Benben stones coming out of the primordial waters. Going right through, we can see the female aspect. And here's a good shot of the Benben stone rising out of the primordial waters. And across this way, besides the waters around the Benben stones, is this female-esque, womb-esque sculpture. Here is what is perhaps another reference to water, being the Medina Hotel here at Railway Square. Here is the Mercure Hotel. There's Eve's Bar. I will point out Orchard Corner also, which perhaps ties in with Eve's Bar here, although it's been here for a much longer time. Here is the bar Eve's Place, which perhaps relates to the Orchard's Corner clock. So here is the Orchard's Corner clock, once again perhaps relating to the Tree of Life with the apples, relating to the Garden of Eden. Just as we can see, Eve's Bar, or Eve's Place, below the Mercure Hotel here at Railway Square.
Looking down from the Mercure Hotel, we see Railway Square here, which was once called Central Square, but it's now called Railway Square. There is symbolism in and around this area. Whether it's there by mistake, or on purpose, or in a synchromystical fashion, I'm not sure. But let's have a look at it anyhow. This building here was built under Marcus Clark, the Freemason, as is this building here, known now as the Marcus Clark building. It's got TAFE in it. So on this building here, we have a company called Wake Up, and within their logo, we have the single eye there,
looking over this part here. So this is perhaps synchromistically a pyramid with the single eye looking over it. Also within here, and perhaps most importantly or relevantly, I think that the creation myth, the Egyptian creation myth, may be incorporated into this area somewhat. So this Benben stone here, or phallus, may represent Atum, or Jeb also. The Atum being the creator god, and Jeb being the earth god. And this part going up here with the three supports and this sort of wiggly design, perhaps DNA-esque design going up, perhaps represents the sperm and the DNA going up. And this part here, there's a lighting rig on top, perhaps, and here it is in the dark here with the lighting rig, perhaps represents the star seed or the seed. And here we have it here. So we would have Jeb or Atum impregnating Nut, the sky goddess, here. So this is perhaps what is represented here. The pyramids in here perhaps represent Orion as well, the Orion belt. And we have that representation here of the three sort of Egyptian pyramids on the Giza Plateau. These perhaps resonate with Orion's belt, and Orion does come up in the creation myth, but there are people who argue that the Cygnus constellation might have something to do or might be represented in the pyramids on the Giza Plateau. So I'm just putting that out there as well. So moving on from that, so that's what we might have here, is these phalluses with sperm and DNA sort of rising up here, and we have the star seed here going up to the goddess Nut. Now, Atum or Jeb, but let's say Atum and Nut, they have offspring, and the offspring are Osiris and Isis. And Isis is known as the Virgin. She's always the Virgin. Even though there are perhaps depictions of her having physical sex, she is the Virgin. And that perhaps relates to the mind more than anything else. The virginal mind, the open mind, and all the rest of it with no indoctrination. So Isis, the Virgin, she gives birth to Horus. And you know, this perhaps relates to Mary and Jesus, of course. And therefore, we dovetail into the Garden of Eden with the apples and so forth, and Eve's bar, and Adam and Eve from the Bible. So we perhaps have this resonation here with these creation myths, if you will. And to find out more about these creation myths, I would advise people look at the work of people like Bill Donahue and Michael Tesarian. So let's move on. Within the Mercure Hotel is the Four Elements restaurant. So the Four Elements, from a Ptolemaic point of view and structure, would perhaps be the earth, and then water, and then air, and then fire. And then one perhaps passes from the fire into the ether, or spirit, if you will. So we'll just have a look in the restaurant. So we're just walking through the restaurant. And we're coming to this round window here, which actually makes a full circle. And that's Railway Square. So here we are outside, and here is that window. So we just walked up to the window here, and as you can see, it has the awning out the front with this scarlet line lining the top here, and we have what are perhaps constellations also under the awning here. So here's some people up here having a meal, and here's yet another shot, some people up here in the Four Elements restaurant having a meal, and we have the some constellations perhaps up here in the stars, in the ether, if you will. Here's another look at those constellations. So we just had a look at the Four Elements restaurant in the Mercure Hotel. This stained glass window is in the St. Andrew's Cathedral of Sydney, and we see what is perhaps Jesus here, clearly in the water. They've taken great care to show his feet in the water, and here he is receiving the water down his back as well. So he is being immersed in the element of water, earth, water, air, and then fire. In this case, water. And then again, on another stained glass window in that church, we have this character here. You can see with the pointed ears. And notice around his head that there's no enlightenment there. He has this grey disc around his head, whereas the others either have coloured discs or discs of light to perhaps show enlightenment. This character is perhaps not enlightened. And here we see his feet in the water here also, and then the element of fire, and then the element of earth. So further portrayals within this church of the elements. So let's move on. So there is the restaurant there, the Four Elements restaurant. And as you can see, this is perhaps also the all-seeing eye here, the all-seeing eye. So the people within the Four Elements restaurant are perhaps looking out here into the ether, the starry ether beyond the elements. Anyhow, this is a door, so you can also walk through here. So it is perhaps like a stargate as well. And this is perhaps planetary-like. So this is the inside and the door here. And notice the this part here that keeps changing colour. This is perhaps a reference to the spectrum, to the colour spectrum, an ode to the colour spectrum of the rainbow. Of course, Freemasons may consider that you have to pass over the rainbow bridge to reach enlightenment, so to speak. So let's have a further look at this. So here are some people as a demonstration coming through that door, and we have the rainbow above. So just a bit of a shot there from the inside. This shot here, we have a character in what is perhaps the sun or a planet right there. I think that's quite an interesting shot. And here's a close-up of that. So this idea of passing through, going up and passing through the planets or through the sun perhaps here, this being the sun, and this person is perhaps in the sun. Here is the Bali terrorist memorial in King's Park in Perth, and we have this pathway going through what is perhaps the sun also. And here again we have the Cirque du Soleil, Soleil meaning the sun, and we have the eye here, the iris, and we are passing through the iris here, into the E perhaps, into the ether. Again, more symbology, that would be the side of the sun. Here we have a celebrity, a celestial celebrity, similar to a celebrant within a church or a civic or doing their civic duties, but we have a celestial, a star, a celestial celebrity here. And what's she doing? Let's take another look here. So this is Kelly Rowland, and she's at Circular Quay in Sydney. And she's passing through this doorway here, in and out of the sun. And the company would be Optus, with their logo YES, and YES perhaps refers to the sun. The sun is the YES. Here we have a float. Now I think this was in the Mardi Gras, and this is the Wizards of Optus, with again some the rainbow here. The Wizards of Optus, the Wizards of of Oz, of course. So we'll move on, but just remember this word here, wizards, because this is part of what this is all about, I think.
So this is Railway Square down here, and up above here we have a billboard with two figures on it relating to, or possibly relating to, north, south, east and west. That's showing down in Canberra with the figure down there. The two Masonic pillars before it. Up above here, on a mural that happens to be on the Mercure Hotel here in Sydney, is a billboard for Pure Blonde beer. We can see the two spirits on either side of the writing there, spirit type creatures, one perhaps being male and one female, positive and negative, male and female, a balance of forces. And I'll just come back from that, perhaps relating to the Masonic pillars.
So I hope you've enjoyed looking at the symbolism, mainly based around Railway Square, and some of the mythology behind that symbolism. I'd just like to conclude this video by just saying that I think there's a whole nother level behind this. A lot of time and energy goes into design, and I think that what is happening here is there is a major story that's untold, and it is still kept within the occult organizations such as Freemasonry. And what I think is happening is that within those organizations, they are bringing through entities. It's not out in the public. It's hardly ever talked about on the internet, but that's just how it is at the moment. So there is a much deeper level behind these symbols and what they can be used for, in my opinion, and we're only just scratching the surface here. We really are, but it's still a start. All the best, and bye for now.